Rayanne Thorne, talking about business for life, living how you know. Let's give it up for Rayanne.
Business for life, basically taking business concepts and applying them to your life. So, the merge of professional and personal is big and real and ongoing right now, isn't it? If you like your job like I do, it melts into the rest of your life. So we got to figure it out, right? Just take it in. Yeah. We're just going to peel the top off this one. Just gonna scratch the surface on this one. Okay, I want you to think for a minute. Close your eyes real quick because I don't want your neighbor seeing how you respond to these questions. Have you ever had an abortion? Have you ever lost a baby? Have you ever had a divorce? Have you ever lost a home? Have you ever lost a job? Have you ever lost a parent, a child? Have you ever gone through serious loss? Have you ever cheated on a loved one? Have they ever cheated on you? You can open your eyes now. Right? All of these things deal with loss. How are you going to deal with loss in your private, personal life when you have to keep going every day? If you're a parent, it doesn't end. If you're a spouse, it doesn't end. If you work full-time, it doesn't end. You ever asked yourself, I need to manage my time. I need to manage my work. I need to manage my life. Oh my God, I need to manage my life. I'm going to give you some tips and tricks on how to manage your life by looking at some business things, okay? Those are real. Tips and tricks for survival in your personal life. One, this is the hardest one of all. Benefit or don't do it. If you are the CEO of a company and somebody comes to you with a project and says, I want to do this, and it's not going to benefit the business, as the CEO, are you going to say, yeah, go ahead and do it? No, don't do it. Be mindful of time. How often do you spend way too much time on Facebook? Yeah, or on Twitter. Be mindful of the time that you spend doing any one thing. Limit your inbox. Hell. What, we're checking emails 36 times a minute? What were you saying? Okay, 4 times a day check email. Limit how much time you check email. Because if you spend so much time in there, it feels like hell. Everybody's grabbing you. They want something from you. They want you to buy something. They want you to sell something to them. They want you to do something for them. This will help you in your personal life. Don't check your personal email 100 times a day. Limit it, okay? Keep a schedule. Notice how keep is bolded. Keep a schedule, right? Have a calendar. Keep it, follow it, use it, all right? Keep it. One of the greatest things ever invented in my life is the location reminder on my cell phone. How many of you use this? Have you used it? It's the best thing ever. I need to remember to feed the dog when I get home or give the dog medicine. As soon as I pull into my driveway, it says, oh, you're home, feed the dog. Right? It's the most fantastic thing. Use apps. And then freedom, put your damn phone down. When you're with your family, put your phone down. You don't need to be holding it all the time. This is for me, as my husband would be laughing right now if he were sitting in the audience hearing me say this. Put the phone down. Okay. Jaws 2. It sucked. Right? Totally jump the shark. Damn it, you stole my line. Totally jump the shark. Okay? Have all of your meetings, appointments, get them in before 2. Try and get them in before 2 so after work, you can concentrate on family and friends and good things. Speak kindly to each other. Be kind to each other. When you're ordering your coffee at Starbucks, be nice to the barista. Say thank you. You will kill them with kindness. Seriously. In the United States, we do not take enough vacations. We don't. Several years ago, a vacation for me was taking half a Friday off. Right? This is normal for us because we work so hard and we love to work. Take vacations. You will benefit from it. Take care. Take care of yourself. Go for walks. Be contemplative. I want to switch it up a little bit though and call it give care. Okay? Give care to yourself. And I'm going to give you one bonus. Give yourself a foreword. Several years ago, I learned about this in playwriting. forwards and backwards. A backwards gives you exposition about a character. A forward is something that they hint at that might happen if they follow the right path. So this is my secret. Give yourself a forward, a goal that you think about and work toward. Know how you're going to get there. Work backward from it. What do I need to do to get to that goal? I did that with getting my degree. As a single mom of four kids, working three jobs, I said, that diploma is in my hand. And damn it, be the CEO of your life, all right? You can't do it by not acting like the CEO. If you're going to be the CEO, act like the CEO. Benefit or don't do it.